Finally, we've been through winter, so welcome to the first spring video! Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lover. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we're talking about spring for an amazing perfume I wanted to talk about since long now. It's still quite cold where I live, but you know, let's forget winter and go through the spring now to just cheer us up and bring a bit of sun. So I'm talking about spring today through an amazing perfumer who is Jean-Claude Elena. I think he's really related to spring because I think most of his scents have that spring kind of touch, and that's why I wanted to talk about it today. And let me tell you a bit more about the perfumer and explain to you how he got his inspiration. So what I like usually about talking about the nose is because most of the creation will have the same DNA, so I think it's really interesting for us to know a bit more of that to understand more the fragrance after. And Jean-Claude Elena, he's got a very interesting story, as his father was actually a professional nose, so you know, it's always heritage and family thing, I think, to be a nose sometimes. And also, what is really nice to know, and I didn't know that before actually, is that Jean-Claude Elena was born in Grasse in France. So for you, that if you don't know where is Grasse, is in the south of France, and it's basically the cradle of perfumery. This is where a lot of amazing flowers are grown over there, and we always say that you get the best quality of flowers in Grasse just because the soil is actually a Mediterranean soil, so it's warm but cooled by the Mediterranean wind. So he was born in 1947 in Grasse, and what is funny is, well, funny, I don't know, but he used to pick flowers with his grandmother, and he used to sell those flowers to the perfumers. So, you know, he was really like, since he's young, into that perfumery influence. Then after that, when he got like a bit more older, he was an apprentice into an essential oil factory. So I think he got to learn a lot around them. And what he used to say as well is that it was mainly for the ingredient of okmos. And you're gonna see that this is quite important in the creation that he's gonna do after. This earthy type of vibe, a very natural as well type of vibe in his fragrances. So that's why I always like call him like the springtime perfumer, because it really has this earthy, fruity, herbaceous, spicy, that it smells very countryside. And in 1968 he actually studied in a very famous school, which is in Geneva, and it's called the Perfumery School of Givaudan. And it's nice because it's actually one of the before being a school, this building was one of the oldest factory in the world for perfumery. Of course, in 2004, he was the main perfumer of Hermès, so you might know him for his Hermès work, because he did a lot of creation from them. He's basically the François de Machy of Dior, or the Jacques Paul, Olivier Paul of Chanel. And he's been working around like different houses few the time, so mainly he was Hermès. So he's done a lot of collection from the exclusive range that are only sold in boutique, Hermèsence collection. So you've done a lot, and I didn't really deep and dive into this collection, and I really want to know more about it, so that might come in a future video hopefully. You've done also all the collection of Un Jardin, you know, Un Jardin sur le Nil, Un Jardin dans la Mousson. I love this one, I really like it. He's done a lot of the Des Merveilles collection, so you have the Elixir, you have the Ambre des Merveilles that you've done, so other reinterpretation of the classic Des Merveilles. And also like perfume, like of course the big Terre d'Hermès, au Voyage d'Hermès, Belle Amie Vetiver One, and Eau d'Orange Verte of course. You've done a lot of the water, kind of like fragrance in Hermès, so eau de pamplemousse rose, eau de neroli doré. All this scent has very that uplifting type of vibe, like slightly fruity, a bit spicy as well. There's always like a little bit of bitterness in this creation. And when you smell it, you can really smell the actual ingredient. It doesn't smell synthetic at all. It really smells like you're around the field and it's springtime, slightly warm, but not too much. And that's why I think is the spring perfumer for me. So he's been working for l'artisan perfumeur, l'eau d'ambre, ambre, bois farine for example. And he's done one of my favorite scents from Van Cleef & Arpels, which is, I don't know if you know them, but originally they create jewelry and they have like a fragrance since a long time out. So he's done a First for example in another edition of First as well. He is doing like Sisley Eau de Campagne. Eau de Campagne is really like a green scent. It's not only smell like very earthy, groundy. Again, a very good seasonal spring scent. Aqua di Parma, Assoluta, always that like uplifting vibe as well, quite citrusy, fresh, but a spicy, earthy dry down. A lot from Frédéric Malle as well, Angélique sous la pluie, Cologne Bigarade, L'eau d'hiver, Rose and Cuir. And there's one from Bulgari that is the Tever one, which I absolutely adore. It's like a tea kind of scent, a bit greener as well. Lovely for springtime again. So what we can see, it's got a very like poetic vision of perfumery, quite natural, that is really like related to how he's been, his education and life. So it's nice to see how your education can influence your future creativity, really. And that's what I like about Jean-Claude Elena's work. He's always like delicate, refined, still very classy, timeless, elegant. He's really for someone that doesn't want to show off but just want to be feeling classy, gentleman or ladylike, you know. And now is the time I'm talking about my three favorite creation from Jean-Claude Elena. So the first one, and this is one of my favorite fragrance ever. This is in the male scent, but I do really think that for me, ladies can wear it really easily because it's such a beautiful scent. Merlin, Eo, tranquille, tranquille, s'il te plaît, voilà. And let me open it, so it's in my lovely Hermes box. So when you order online, it comes in those little box, and I found that is absolutely amazing. And it's not like a simple box inside, there's a little thingies like this, like to put your fragrance inside. So I'm not showing you because there's a few in there. So Terre d'Hermès, timeless classic, for me a masterpiece, technically. I don't say that a lot. For this one, it deserves it. T'as fini ou quoi? So that's Terre d'Hermès coming in this little box like this. And then the scent is here. I love this bottle, first of all, like you twist it like this to have your scent, so it's not the usual cap. I think it's really nice. It's definitely, you've got the H at the back as well. And I think it definitely shows a lot of elegance on it. It's really a bottle, I think, for me, beautiful. You don't need a lot in your bottle to make it like very classy. And also you can really see that there's an influence around horse riding, like for me, like with the gray brown thing. And that's something that you can usually see in Hermès, that they have like really this influence of horse riding. And I think for me, horse riding is like related to a bit aristocracy as well. And you can really smell that in the bottle because it's always classy and classic. What I like about Terre d'Hermès is a perfect balance for me of grapefruit orange in the top notes, and then it dries out really in pepper, and this is really what I can smell. It's a profusion of pepper but not too much. It's like nicely balanced with the orange bitterness, and you've got really a dry down that is very earthy, like so earthy, with the vetiver. And this is a vetiver that is not too green, very delicate, not opulent. And like longevity of this, I don't know how it works, but it's ages, and that's what I really like. You can really smell around you during the day this peppery type of vibe, and I think for me it makes it the best scent of spring, of summer. To be honest, I wore in winter, but the bitterness is really nice when there's a touch of ray on sunlight and it's slightly more warmer. But yeah, for me, like, if a man is looking for a scent, or even for a lady, because I love to wear it myself, my mom used to wear it a lot, this is for me one of the best designer you will find. And then the second creation I do really enjoy is basically, I've talked about it recently in my feminine fragrance for confidence video, and it's for me like a little bit of a flow feminine interpretation of Terre d'Hermès, and it's Kelly Kalesh. What I love about this is you clearly have a touch to the fashion icons of Hermès, because you've got the little lock over there that is usually on the bags, and I really love that everything is related together. Again, you twist it like this, so exactly like Terre d'Hermès, so it really shows clearly the inspiration and the link between the two. The greenness more for this one comes from the Narcissus and the Mimosa. Mimosa is very powdery, so that's what you give to the fragrance. So it's fruity grapefruit, like tone down really the greenness of the Narcissus and especially the Mimosa. And again, you have in this one a bit more, I would say, strong touch with a touch of leather, but it's really nicely balanced. And it's a very powdery scent. Fruity, the lily gives a bit of flowery side as well, that is lovely, I think. And yeah, it's got really that spiciness that offers Terre d'Hermès. So again, like, very classy scent, and this is one of my favorite scents for spring, because I think for spring you need to keep like this drag down a bit earthy. For me, like, it's really like, for me, spring is like everything is blossoming, so it's not very intense, but it needs to have like a green or woody dry down still, but not as much as the winter would be. So for me, the citrus needs to be a bit more over there, but without forgetting a quite like warm dry down. And the leather does it perfectly in this one, and it really gives me that, really, if I'm wearing that, I will have like a very classic outfit. And and yeah, so that's the two, one of my favorite. And there's one I don't have in my collection. I used to have it because I used to work for them actually at some point when I started my studies. I was having an internship with them, well, actually with the group that is with them, but it's Van Cleef & Arpels that I've talked a bit earlier in the video, so that jewelry house. But they do like lovely fragrance as well with a lot of quality. And one of the ones that Jean-Claude and Elena did is First, and First is really for me in the line of a number five, in the line of Joy from Jean Patou, for example, because it's an aldehydic scent, so it's very vintage, ultra vintage. The aldehydes is a molecule that gives like that fizziness to a fragrance, nearly like champagne like, and this is what it gives me. Of course, you have a lot of flowers, like a profusion of flowers, but jasmine, rose, tuberose, ylang-ylang, carnation, like so many flowers. But really, the flowers that are the star of the fragrance in there are the green flowers. She's Narcissus and Hyacinthe. You always have that green, slightly leaves-like type of scent, and this is what I really enjoyed in this scent. It gives that really like green vibe, and I think for the spring as well, it's so beautiful. The dry down is really woody. You've got a lot of tonka bean and everything like that, but it doesn't smell sweet at all. I think for me, the base is quite softened, and really the moisture I can smell in the base is the okmos. And this is quite funny that it shows okmos, I think, to be like one of the strongest base. Maybe it's related to where I used to work for the essential oils that I've been talking about in the beginning of the video. But yeah, it really showed me that. And First, now you can have it for like nothing, and it's such a nice scent. If you like vintage aldehydic type of scent, go for First. I mean, I remember like when I used to advise First, it was for the client that used to really like classic vintage scent, like if the lady liked number five, if she liked Arpège from Lorvin, things like that, I will go, you need a First, and usually they love it. And the bottle is very cute. You have a little round like this when you spray, so you put your finger in the little round and you spray it like that, and it looks like a little drop of something. So It's very charming scent, and it really goes into my vintage type of fantasy. But yeah, so that's my three favorite scent of Jean-Claude Elena, and it's definitely one of my favorite perfumer for that spring type of vibe. And this is why I'm gonna get like few of his scent for spring, because I think it's the best thing. I really want that eau de neroli doré. I really want one of the jardin. Un jardin sur le dans la mousson is one. Love it. Sur le Nil as well, I think is one of the best of the collection. So yeah, there's a lot of things to get, and I really want to get that Bulgari Thé Vert as well. So I think it gives me a lot of inspiration for my top spring scent. But yeah, so that's it for me today. I hope you enjoyed the video. I will see you very shortly in another video. I hope you're having a nice start of the week, and I will see you soon. Bye now.